Welcome back. This is Metropole Business Center, and on this part of our show, in which we are focusing on Steel Matters technology, we take a look at today's gadget review segment, and I'm joined by Joe Wanjara. Welcome, Joe.
Thank you so much for having me, Mr. Steven.
All right. Take us through today's gadgets.
Okay, so today we are looking at, let me just say that it's the festive season, yeah? So people are spending time with their friends and family, and one important thing to do right now is to capture those precious moments. So for today's version of gadget review, I'm going to take you through three cameras that will help you capture these moments. So these cameras cut across in terms of the situation you're in, whether you're in a rural setup or urban setup, whether you're a beginner with a camera or a professional, you're going to find at least one that suits your needs. So going straight into it, the first camera is the Fujifilm Instax Mini 9. Now, this is an instant camera. So what does that mean? It means it's a portable camera and a printer at the same time. So basically, when you take a photo, the photo is printed immediately, right on the spot. That's really amazing. So all you need to have is the Fujifilm film that you insert inside the camera. And then once you take the photo is printed right on the spot. Now, this is very important if you are in a rural setup or you are in a place where you don't have access to a printer to print your photos, or if you want to leave your photos to the person you want them for, and you really can't go to a place where you want to print them, this will be the camera for you. It comes in different colors. There's the white, there's blue, there's pink, there's yellow, there's green. So you know, it suits anyone really. And it actually is very affordable. Let's check the price. Yeah, it goes for 11,000 Kenya shillings, 11,500, and you can buy this at Jumia. Now next is the Akaso Brave 7. The Akaso Brave 7 is an action camera. Now, what's an action camera? An action camera is a very, very small portable camera that you can mount on anything. You can mount on your helmet, on your wrist, basically anywhere. It's usually used for people who want to go hiking, if you want to, you know, record underwater, if you want to record while you're cycling. This is the kind of camera for you. Now, it's a very cheap alternative to what people refer to as the industry standard, which is the GoPro Hero 8, which goes for around 45,000 Kenya shillings. This one is actually very affordable. We'll come to the price in a few. Now, for now, let's just look at the specs. So it's a 20-megapixel camera. It shoots at 4K at 30 frames per second, which is actually very decent. It has Wi-Fi if you want to wirelessly transfer your footage. It also has a remote control because basically you're going to mount it on your helmet, so you won't have time to adjust it on the go. So it has a remote control for your hand. It has an image stabilizer because the activities you're going to do are going to, you know, make the camera shake often. So it has an electronic image stabilizer, which is actually very nice. It has a dual screen display, so you can see whatever you're recording on the front and also on the back. It's also a touch screen, so whatever settings you want to adjust, you really will adjust them really quickly. And one very important thing about this camera is that it is water resistant. So like I said, if you want to go and record underwater, under the ocean, under the swimming pool, this is the camera for you. And I've told you before that the GoPro goes for around 45,000 Kenya shillings. Now this goes for only 14,000 Kenya shillings. Now that's really affordable, if you ask me. Now, lastly, on our list, we have the Nikon D3500. Now, this is a professional camera, and it's a DSLR. DSLR basically means it's a digital single lens reflex camera. So, you know, the light comes in through the lens into the mirror, and your photo is produced that way. So, it's a professional camera, but this one is designed specifically for beginners. It also has an inbuilt guide mode for you to understand how to use it if you're not really exposed to this kind of camera. So this is actually very important if you want to take professional photos. We're talking professional photos that you'll probably upload on your, you'll probably use as your portfolio. probably take it to a client, or if you want to basically edit your photos after you take the photos, this will be the camera for you. Let's just jump right into the specs. It is a 24.2 megapixel camera. That's really nice. It shoots at full HD at 60 frames per second. It has Bluetooth connectivity if you want to, again, transfer your footage wirelessly. It also has a 3-inch LCD screen display on the back for you to easily access the settings. And like I mentioned, it has a guide mode if you are a beginner with this kind of camera. And one very important thing is that you can actually change the lens. Most of these entry-level cameras usually have fixed lens. So if it comes with a normal lens, you cannot change it to maybe a wide-angle lens. So this one actually has the option for you to change the lenses, which is actually something you should always consider when you're buying a digital DSLR. Now, how much does this go for? This one goes for around 42,000 Kenya shillings at cameraafrica.com. Competitors or other cameras like this will go for up to 300,000 Kenya shillings. So 42,000 Kenya shillings is fair enough for anyone who wants to take professional photos on a budget. Yes, so that's all we had for you for today. I believe you will consider one of these cameras, considering the kind of needs you want the camera for. And if you want to catch this again, you can watch it live on YouTube today in the afternoon on our YouTube channel. That's Metropole TV Kenya. Back to you, Mr. Steven.
Thanks a lot, Joe, for your excellent exposition of those three cameras that our viewers can consider as we get into the holiday season.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Now, before we wind up this show today, let's take a look at today's cybersecurity tip. And the tip is to make sure that your devices remain secure, both whether you're working or using those devices for personal use, please ensure, and especially this has been very key this year, secure your Wi-Fi. Because most routers have a default username and password, and those are credentials that can be easily found on the internet. So always secure your Wi-Fi. And it is recommended, experts do recommend, that one sets up a new password and update the router's firmware every so often in order to ensure that your Wi-Fi remains as secure as possible. And that's the cybersecurity tip of the week as we end Metropole Business Center. This is our last show this year, and we'll be catching up next year with more from the world of technology and more from the world of business and economics on this show, Metropole Business Center. My name is Stephen Kimani. Do enjoy the rest of your viewing, and have happy holidays.